Good morning to all of you. Welcome to your English 1 class. Today we will read the chapter Verbs, Active and Passive Voice. Ever since we are introduced to English grammar, we all are acquainted with this chapter, that is Active and Passive Voice. We will learn this chapter in detail and we will complete the exercises mentioned in this particular chapter over here. So before we start, it is mandatory for all of you to open the book and stay tuned to this page number 64. So let us begin. Before we start this, we need to know, why do we change the voice? When we are talking about an active verb, it actually tells us about what a subject does. Okay. And when we are talking about a passive verb, it actually tells us what is done to the subject. For example, I eat rice. I is a subject here. What am I doing? I eat rice. Okay. So the subject here eats rice. That is in active voice. When we are talking about the passive voice, rice is eaten by me. So here the passive verb tells us about what a subject actually does. Okay, so it's very easy. We all are known to all this. As it is given here, somebody picked up my pocket yesterday. It is given in active. What we will write in passive? My pocket was picked yesterday. We use an active verb to say what the subject does. For example, the crowd blocked the roads. If we change it to passive, the roads were blocked by the crowd, right? So similarly, we use passive verb to say what is done to the subject. For example, the crowd was driven away from the market. Or else we can say tea is drunk all over the world. We can understand. So there we can see a series of rules that are generally followed while we change the voice. Okay. So we will start with the beginning. So my pocket was picked in the fair. Suppose my pocket was picked in the fair. This was given in your exam. What will you write? We do not know that who has picked it. So what we will write? My pocket was picked in the fair. What we will write here? What we will write? My pocket was picked. Someone picked my pocket. Okay? Because we do not know who has done all that. So, it is natural to use the active voice. Sentences in the active voice are always very active, simple and elegant. It is easier to understand them. Passive voice is preferred when it is preferred, we do not know who has performed the action. We are not quite sure about the doer or the subject. The action itself is very important, then who performed it or what caused it doesn't matter. Here we will talk about the passive verb, or we will generally change the voice from active to passive. So we will start doing it. In passive voice, we use past participle form. So I'll ask you to write down the rule. In passive voice, we generally use the past participle form of the verb along with an appropriate form of the auxiliary be. So this be can be changed according to the tense and according to the situation. Okay? And we will always be using the past participle form of the verb. Future continuous and past continuous tenses do not have passive forms. Keep in your mind. Future continuous and perfect continuous tenses do not have passive forms. Okay, so we will only talk about future indefinite or simple future tense. Okay. Now here, let us have this. Detransitive verbs can have two passive forms. Detransitive, it has two objects. So, his colleagues gave him a present. So, gave him. Him is what? Him is indirect object and present is direct object. So, this can be changed. This voice change can be done following both the ways. We can take any of this objects. So, he was given a present. Okay. Here we are talking about, we are actually changing the indirect object. Next, if we write, a present was given to him. This is the direct object we are talking about. So, in both the ways, this can be done. Okay. Now, here it is given. There is a table, as you can see. And the table consists of three columns. Here we are talking about invite, will become, is, am, are according to the subject. Then the past participle form, as I said. So, invite will become is, am, are, then invited. Okay. Then if invited is given, then was or were invited. If will invite is given, then the answer will be invited. Then is, am, are inviting, is, am, are being invited. Continuous tense we are talking about. Has, have invited, has, have been invited. Would invite, would be invited or would have been invited. May, might, can, we can write can be invited or could have been invited. So, this, if you read out this column properly, I think all the answers can be solved by you and without taking anybody's help. Just mark my words. So, let us begin with the first exercise. Before that, it is given, as I told you all, somebody rings a bell every half an hour. The answer will be what? A bell is rung every half an hour. No need to write about that somebody. We know if the bell is being rung, it means somebody is doing that. So, no need to mention about it. So, let us begin with exercise 1. I'll ask you to write the football World Cup. Okay, what is the instruction? Fill in the blanks with passive form of the verbs in the simple present tense. So, here the simple, the simple present form of the verb is given in the bracket. So, we need to change according to the requirement because we are going to change it from active to passive. So, let us do this. The Football World Cup is held every 4 years. An honest man is respected everywhere. All houses owners are required to pay house tax. Mother's Day is celebrated to focus on the role of mother in our life. Children are not allowed to carry cell phones to the school. All the coaches are thoroughly cleaned at the last station. Are these children regularly sent to medical checkup? How much fee is charged for a 3-month revision course? So, it is done. Now, you can do this exercise 3 on your own. Read the simple method of preparing delicious vegetables too. So, it is given here the process of making vegetables too. So, the ingredients are mentioned as well as the method is nicely written. So, what do you have to do? Rewrite the method using simple present tense passive forms of the verbs. So, suppose it is given wash and cut the vegetables. So, you will be writing like vegetables are washed and cut. Like this, you will be doing. You are actually going to change from active to passive since it is given in simple present. You know the rule of simple present. Either you have to use am, is, are according to that what any form of the auxiliary verb that goes well according to the subject, and then the past participle form of the base verb. Understood? So you can do on your own. Then here we will do what? We will be just doing simple past tense. We will be changing the sentences that are already given in simple past tense from active to passive. The damaged goods were sold at half rate. The instructions were not issued in time. The child was gently laid in the bed. Bravery Award winners were honored by the president. This news was telecast by all the news channels. The plural of telecast is telecast only. Were any refreshments served to the guests? Were any vegetables washed before they were cooked? Done. Then we will learn about what? Simple future. Okay. So, for example, simple future. For example, somebody will send the invitation cards today. So, what somebody will send what the invitation card? So, this invitation card is what? That is direct object. So, this what we will write? The invitation cards will be sent today. Okay, as it is given will, we will be just adding be with that, and then the past participle of the base verb. So according to this rule, let us do this exercise number 6. All the rules will be explained to you. I am sure all landscaping jobs will be completed. Efforts will be made to generate as many jobs as possible. The nation's interest will be protected at all costs. The final result will be prepared with the help of a computer. Will I be given time to think? When will the team be announced? Okay. Now, here what we are asked to do? We will be doing present continuous tense. Oh, what is the rule of present continuous tense? We all know present continuous tense. Either am, is, are, and then ing will be there. So, how we will change it? We will be just using the auxiliary verb according to the subject. Then, we will be just adding something extra, that is being. And then, again, the past participle form of the verb and the rest. Okay. For example, we can write like somebody is tapping our phone. What will be the answer? Our phone is being tapped. No need to write by somebody. Because since it is tapped, it has to be done by somebody. So it doesn't make sense. No need to write. Okay. So following this rule only, let us do this exercise 8. Some of these islands are being developed as tourist spots. A Bharatnatyam Academy is being set up in Chennai. All flights on this route is being diverted to Mumbai. Are any steps being taken to control global warming? Whose car is being towed away? Towed means pulled away. Why am I being harassed for no fault of mine? Okay. So next what we will do, we will be just doing past continuous tense. The same thing will be there. Instead of am, is, are, we will be just using either was or were. The rest will be exactly the same. So I found that the customers were being treated very politely. The tickets were not being sold in advance. The bags and purses were thoroughly being checked at the entrance. The table was being laid when the guests arrived. are the fields being plowed when it started raining? Why were so many trains being cancelled? Okay, it's done. Now we will do present perfect tense. Okay, the workers have called off the strike, that is given in active. So we will be taking the strike that is given there in the object place, in the active sentence. We will be taking that object part. So the strike, instead of have, we will write has, because along with, according to this subject, we will be using has, not have, since it is in singular. So the strike has, then we will add what? Been, B-E-E-N, been, then the past participle form of the base verb. So the strike has been called off by the workers, no need to write. Okay, so following this rule, let us do exercise 12. The segment of the highway has been closed to traffic for about a week. Now we cannot go in. All the gates have been closed. CCTV cameras have been installed at the strategic points. Then, has the car been sent for servicing? Where in the library have all the new books kept? Whose drawing has been adjudged the best? Adjudged means what? Adjudged means declared. Okay, so we will do what? Now present perfect tense. According to that, it's something very interesting. Here are a number of news headlines. Convert them into complete sentences using the passive form of the present perfect tense. So we just have to complete the sentence. For our better understanding, the first one is already done. New sales tax policy announced. New sales tax policy has been announced by the government. So we will be adding one object according to the meaning of the sentence. Okay, here we will be adding actually a subject, but it will be used in the place of the object. Workers' demand accepted. Workers' demands have been accepted by the owner. Control price of sugar has been raised by the marketeer, by the black marketeer, we can say rather. Notorious gangster has been arrested by the police. Vegetable market has been shifted to a new site. No need to write by somebody. Obviously, the vendors have done that, so no need to write. The new Rajiv Chowk flyover declared open. Okay, the new Rajiv Chowk flyover has been declared open by the authority, we can write. Entrance examination has been put off indefinitely by the board. Okay, so following this rule, let us do, since it is done, we will be doing following the same rule exactly, but instead of has or have, we will be just adding had. Okay, we have to replace has or have with had, as we are doing it, what? We are doing past perfect, not present one. So the house had been auctioned before we reached there. A statement had already been released to the press on important issues. A warning had already been given to the striking workers. The orders had already been issued when we received your letter. Had the papers been leaked before the examination started? Okay. Then future perfect. Okay. Future perfect. See. Will have invited. What it will be? Will have been invited. Okay, for example, civic authorities will have demolished these houses by the end of the month. So, these houses will have been demolished by the end of the month. That will be done in passive. Okay, so here we will now learn how to change the sentence while this model is there in the active ones. One can't move mountains. If it is given in active, what will be the answer? If we want to change it from active to passive, mountains can't be moved. So either we will be using be and then the past participle form of the base verb, or we will be using have or has, then been, not have or has, only have, because before that we will be using the model, and while we will use the model we can't just write has, we have to write have. So should have been or could have been or would have been, okay, and then the past participle form of the verb. So yes, let us do. Traffic rules should have been strictly obeyed. Success cannot be achieved without hard work. The news may have telecast by now. Promises ought to be kept. Honest taxpayers should have been suitably rewarded. This mistake could have been avoided if you had been a little careful. Your problems cannot be solved in a single day. If you continue making so much noise, the baby might have been disturbed. Okay, so now we will learn imperative. This is very, very easy. So suppose you have said do it. So we can change this using two different methods. One is we can start with let. So do it. We can write let it be done. We can also write like it should, may, might, ought to, must be done. Okay, so according to the, we have to understand the mood of the sentence. So according to that, we will be just using either you are requested to, or you are advised to, or you are ordered to. Okay, so we need to understand the meaning and the mood of the sentence. For example, don't tell him anything. Let him not be told anything, we can write. We can also write he shouldn't be told anything, or we can also write you requested not to tell him anything. Okay, so this is imperative. Please keep quiet. Please is given, obviously someone is requesting you, so you are requested to keep quiet. Lock the door at night. This can be a request, but moreover I think it will be a piece of advice. So we can write you are advised to lock the door at night. Leave the room sounds like an order, so you are ordered to leave the room. Sentences beginning with let your son manage the factory. Okay, so let the factory be managed by your son. Let your secretary type this letter. Let this letter be typed by your secretary. Okay, so here you are asked to write the sentences in the passive. So you can do it on your own. For example, read the instructions carefully. So you are advised to read the instruction carefully, or let the instructions be read carefully. So you do. This is completely your task. I am not going to solve this, but I will discuss that in the live class. Now infinitive. I want you to leave me alone. Infinitive. What is the rule? I want to be left alone. So we will be just using to be and then the past participle. Okay. So let us begin. Fill in the blanks with active infinitive, passive infinitives. So the verbs are given in the boxes. The first one is done for us. The medicine is to be taken thrice a day. According to that, we will be doing the rest 5. I want tea is to be served around 6 a.m. We had no operators. The bills had to be prepared manually. then the meeting is going to be held at my house. Okay, then the income tax return is to be filed by the end of this month. The water is to be filtered first. Okay, and yes, last we will be just reading, like when we don't find there is a scope to change from active to passive following the traditional rules, how would we make that. It is said that it is he is 105 years old, 105 years old. So it is said that, so he is said to be 105 years old in passive. Because it is given here, people say that he is 105 years old. People say that he is 105 years old. He is 105 years old. That we can't change. But people say we can change. It is said that, or he is said to be. So these two rules can be followed. Following this, you can do this oral practices. Here you try to do on your own first, and then we will discuss in detail in the live classes. It's very easy. Just you need to complete the exercises on your own. Even if you after doing that, if you find any problem is there, I'm there to solve that out. Anyways, I am going to provide all the details in the worksheet section. So in the study material section, so you please go and have a look. I think no problem will be there. And the rest, this oral practices part, I'll be asking in the live class. So be prepared well, and you know, give your best. This chapter is the easiest and the most important one. So till then, we are till then, take care of yourself, do study well. We are meeting in the next class with a new chapter. And as I always say, have a good day, and stay safe, stay happy always. Bye bye.